Here off the Farallon Islands in 1997, an orca kills a great white and starts to consume it in front of horrified tourists. The sharks deserted the Farallons for many months after, somehow detecting the clear and present danger.
That's a great white there, right where the shark is, just got him!
In 2015, off South Australia, a tourist captures the orcas hunting great whites once again.
Oh my God!
The California and Australia incidents involved juvenile great whites. So, how do a pair of orca that are possibly injured or compromised take on a 16-foot adult great white? To find out how they may have pulled it off, shark filmmaker Andy Casagrande is studying how orca kills sharks in New Zealand.
Great white shark versus killer whale, it's like the holy grail for shark filmmakers.
His guide, orca expert, Dr. Ingrid Visser.
Yes, I've seen them hunting sharks, and lots of different species of sharks too. It's not something that they're just doing willy-nilly. They target the sharks and they're very precise about how they do it.
By documenting Dr. Visser's research, Andy hopes he can help Allison's investigation back in South Africa.
Obviously, I heard about the killing spree last May. Great white sharks washed up dead, killed by orca. But you know what? Orcas kill a lot of sharks here in New Zealand as well.
In New Zealand, Andy wants to find out how orcas kill adult great whites and remove their livers.
Why would an orca target a great white shark? Orcas hunting great whites just sounds like a celebrity deathmatch battle that just doesn't seem real.
When you realize that orca, just like us, have culture, and one of the driving forces of that culture is the type of prey that they hunt, and then how they actually deal with that prey.
Dr. Visser believes that orca may begin shark hunting with smaller, less threatening species before working their way up to the great white. This amazing footage, recently captured by Dr. Visser, reveals how orca team up to hunt a shark. In this case, the victim is a seven-gill.
In some instances, they will herd the shark up to the surface and use the surface of the water like a barrier. And then they'll swing around and the orca will lift their tail out of the water and they'll actually karate chop on top of the shark to debilitate it. The other thing that I've seen them do is corral them up so the orca will sort of herd around a shark and the sharks get very, very nervous. I've seen one shark try and climb into the back of my boat to get away from the orca.
This seven-gill shark is fighting back against the orca, but it's overmatched and outnumbered.
So the shark said, well, I've got two options, either be eaten or get the hell out of here. And he got right out of there, but up onto the rocks, and he was completely high and dry. I just couldn't leave it there, so I went over and I rescued the shark and put it back.
It looks like the seven-gill has escaped certain death, but just out of sight, the orcas are watching and waiting.
I think what's going on in the orca's mind is that they're very aware that this is a shark, an animal, a prey item that could do harm. So they're cautious about that, how they go about it. It's a high-risk adventure to go and hunt a shark.
This chase has been going on for over an hour. Exhausted and cornered, the end is near. It's no surprise that Dr. Visser's footage shows the shark being ripped apart and stripped of its liver. It's likely the same hunting technique that the orca in South Africa are using to kill massive great whites. Thank you. though no one has actually seen an orca take out a great white. This computer simulation, based on Dr. Visser's observations, shows us how it might look.
When they come in after they've debilitated the shark, and whether that's a karate chop or a ramming, then they tend to try and flip it upside down, and that induces tonic immobility, and then the shark basically becomes catatonic and it'll just lie there. And at that stage, the orca will come in and they'll typically grab it by the pectoral fin, and then they'll give it a good shake viciously, violently, very, very hard. And when you're underwater, you can actually hear the shark ripping, and it sounds like Velcro being ripped apart. And then they're going after the liver. And that's the real thing that they're targeting. It's the liver that they're after.